Morning, children. This is Sunita Chadha, and I welcome you again to this learning class. And I hope all of you are in good state of health. Dear children, we read about heat part 1. Now today, we will study about heat part 2, that is transfer of heat by conduction, convection, radiation. Why do we use cotton or woolen clothes in summers or winters? So first of all, let me start with transfer of heat. Heat flows from a body of high temperature to a body of lower temperature. This is called transfer of heat. Heat is transferred in 3 different ways. They are number 1, conduction, number 2, convection, and number 3, radiation. Now, conduction. Conduction is the process by which heat is transferred in solids from hotter end to colder end. This we can prove by an activity. That is, take an iron or aluminium rod or strip, fix a few wax pieces on it at equal distances, clamp the rod to a stand, heat the other end of the rod, the wax pieces begin to melt and fall down from the heated end. This shows that heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end by conduction. Now, conductors and insulators. Conductors are the materials which allow heat to pass through them easily. For example, iron, aluminium, copper, etc. Insulators are the materials which do not allow heat to pass through them easily. For example, wood, plastic, glass, rubber, air, water, etc. Convection. Convection is the process by which heat is transferred in liquid and gases from the hotter part to the colder part. We can perform an activity to see this. Take some water in a round bottom flask. Keep it on a tripod stand. Put a crystal of copper or potassium permanganate in it. Heat it with a burner. The water at the bottom becomes hot and rises up. And the cold water from the top moves down. This water becomes hot and rises up. And cold water from the top moves down. And the process continues till the water gets heated. This shows that heat is transferred by convection. Now, convection in air, that is how it takes place in air. The air near the heat sources gets heated and rises up. The air from the other side moves in to take its place. In this way, air gets heated. If you keep one hand above a flame and one hand on the side of the flame, the hand at the top of the flame feels hot because the air above is heated by convection. The hand at the side does not feel hot because there is no convection. Now, sea breeze and land breeze. Sea breeze. During the day, the land gets heated faster than the sea. So, the air above the land gets heated, becomes hotter and rises up. And the cold air from the sea moves towards the land. This is called sea breeze, land breeze. During the night, sea cools down slowly than the land. So the hot air above the sea rises up and cool air from the land moves towards the sea. This is called land breeze. Radiation is the process by which heat is transferred from one place to another without the help of any medium. For example, heat from the sun reaches the earth by radiation. When we sit near a fire, we feel warm due to the heat radiated by the fire. All hot bodies radiate heat. Heat from the sun. You feel the sun warm. Your skin on a sunny day. This is because the energy causes the particles in your skin to move faster, which is more than the heat. This is because of heat energy. Dark colored surfaces and light colored surfaces. Dark colored surfaces absorb more heat than light colored surfaces. We can prove this by an experiment. Take 2 tin cans of the same size. Paint the outer surface of one black and the other white. Pour equal amounts of water in each and leave them in sunlight for 1 hour. Measure the temperature in both the cans. The water in the black can is warmer than the water in the white can. Now, dark colored surfaces radiate more heat than the light colored surfaces. Again, we can prove this by an experiment. Take two tin cans of the same size. Paint the outer surface of one black and the other white. Pour equal amounts of hot water of the same temperature, say 60 degrees C. Leave them in a room or shade for 10 to 15 minutes. Measure the temperature of water in both the cans. The water in the black can is cooler than the water in the white can. Now, the kinds of clothes we wear in summer and winter. Children, dark colored surfaces absorb more heat than light colored surfaces. And dark colored surfaces radiate more heat than the light colored surfaces. That is why we wear dark colored clothes in winter because it absorbs more heat and keeps us warm. We wear light colored clothes in summer because it reflects more heat and keeps us cool. We wear woolen clothes in winter because wool is poor conductor of heat and the air in between the wool fibers prevent loss of heat from the body. So we feel warm. So conduction, convection and radiation pictures are given here, children. You can understand it clearly. And that is the end of the chapter. Question answers will be sent in next video. Dear children, if there is any query you can ask, good day. I hope you will. Keep yourself healthy, stay in and stay healthy. Thank you, children.